the holiday feeling that starts in the air. Then you emerge from the clouds to a place where your time is your own, where you have the freedom to be happy-go-lucky or pamper yourself in the lap of luxury, where you can dive into adventure, nourish your body and feed your soul. A place where you can plan every step or take it as it comes. This is your Samoan holiday, and it's always gonna be beautiful. Beautiful Samoa.
Malole soi fua maua, warm Pacific greetings. Welcome to beautiful Samoa. A bit of a wet day today, but this is the home of the 16th Pacific Games.
Kala Palava, a fio mai, that was a shot of Apia Park you saw earlier. It's currently raining, but here in the Pacific, the rain is blessings from the heavens, and it has not dampened the mood here in Samoa. There is an overflow of excitement here in Samoa, and we are live from the IBC studio here at Paleata Sports Complex.
Now, this is the biggest sport event in the Pacific, and for the first time in high definition. Now, we're going to be live via New Zealand through Sky Sport and beaming out to the world on the Olympic Channel. And over the next 2 weeks, there will be around 5,000 athletes making this the biggest games ever. Now, they will be representing 24 nations and competing in 27 sports.
This will also be the third time that Samoa has played host to the games, with 2007 being the most recent year.
Fantastic. Rona, I understand that they're calling this the Miracle Games. Samoa had like 14 months to put this on.
Only 14 months, but Samoa is game ready. John and I will be bringing you live coverage of the games to wherever you are around the world every day from Upolu to Savai. And wherever you are, we've got you covered.
That's right. Now, One in Spirit is the slogan for this year's Pacific Games, which is a call to action for the many teams that are here to be one in spirit to deliver a very successful event.
We will celebrate our athletes as they compete for one of 2,300 medals up for grabs. And we are also taking a very united, firm stand against single-use plastic and greening up the games to manage waste during the games.
Now, it's a sold-out crowd tonight at the opening ceremony. We're really excited. We've got KJ behind us. He's our Siva Afi dancer behind us. But the opening ceremony will feature more than 2,000 students from 16 secondary schools who will perform the legend of Lea Teo Ngie and his father Fepo in the ancient game of Aingofie.
The opening ceremony is a combination of culture, sports and uniting to fight against climate change. We will now go across to Brendan Taufa and Rerona Parker over at Apia Park.
The 16th edition of the Pacific Games. Well, it's a beautiful evening here in Apia. It's been overcast all day, and in fact we had rain here this afternoon. It certainly kept temperatures down, but the beautiful news is that the rain let up just about half an hour or so, maybe an hour or so ago. Forecast is pretty good for the duration of the opening ceremony. There is a slight threat of showers. We, as I said, had a few earlier, but it looks like everybody's going to be dry and very comfortable, and we're not too far away from the parade of athletes.
Well, you know, Brendan and Ken, I think this Pacific Games has been coined the Miracle Games, because not only, as you mentioned, 17 months into to prepare, it's been raining right throughout the week, but look at it, halfway through the beginning of the ceremony, and we've just It just cleared up.
Well, I tell you what, Samoa is probably one of the only countries in the Pacific that could, at such short notice, be able to stage such an epic event. And it's testament, I think, to the will and the perseverance. And we saw a shot there of the Prime Minister just a moment ago, a man who I think is probably very much involved
indeed.
In this process as well.
Absolutely.
So a big night. We were saying, Kenny, Samoa hosts arguably the biggest ever Pacific Games. 24 countries, 27 sports, almost 5,000 athletes, and we're just about to meet them all in the parade of the athletes. Well, I must say, Ken, the night looks a lot better than it did an hour or two ago with all that rain. Things really clearing up now. Beautiful spectacle. And the youth of the Pacific about to parade here.
Well, we are about to, I think the colors, the excitement, the atmosphere is just right to let all the countries of the nation, the 24 countries, parade this Apia Park and let the nations know that they are here to win gold.
Three times, New Caledonia three times, Papua New Guinea three times, Tahiti and Guam twice, and Samoa for the third time host the Pacific Games.
And indeed, the hosts of the 2015 Pacific Games, Papua New Guinea, parading here, leading out the athletes tonight. One of the big players in Pacific sports these days. A big team here in Samoa this week as well. Well-trained, highly qualified, very talented, and PNG a formidable competitor these days as well.
Yeah, it's just under 9 million population. And they did a wonderful job in 2015 hosting the Pacific Games in Port Moresby. They won 88 gold medals in the biggest countries in the Pacific. The money investment on the infrastructure and the delivery of the games of 2015. It was a pleasure, Brendan, you and I to be there. It was an outstanding game.
It was absolutely incredible. But Papua New Guinea here, given the honour to lead out the athletes here tonight, some very famous names, names that we're going to be getting to meet as well. And I believe their flag bearer tonight is the champion tennis player, Abigail Terry Apisa. Some of the netball girls going through at the moment. Very powerful Papua New Guinea team. Their track and field team that we're expected to see in the second week of competition here as well will certainly be highly competitive, Ken.
Yes, boxing, football and rugby league, of course, the national game in Papua New Guinea. What a team, what a performance it was from them in their home country.
I believe this is one of the biggest contingency of this Pacific Games, Brendan.
I think you're right, Verona. Yep. They certainly are, and as you can see, a very big statement here. Indeed, it reflects, I think, the government up there, which believes that investing in sports is very, very important. A positive step, they say, to building a strong and healthy society and future leaders of sport as well.
Absolutely.
We're going to be seeing a couple of their weightlifters in action in the first week of competition here. We've got Deka Tour, who's going to be leading out the competition. She was the first ever female athlete at Olympic Games. She'll be competing in the first round of competition as well.
The excitement from Papua New Guinea, few of us will forget the experience. Verona talked about the colour and the spectacle and the emotion. Opening and closing ceremonies along with the organisation of the games in Papua New Guinea was a real feature of the experience for all of us to be a small part of it.
Couple of good rugby touch out there as well, Ken. They're defending both the men's and the women's gold medals in touch rugby. As I said, Terry Apisa is currently one of the top ranked. In fact, she is the top ranked Oceania tennis player in the world. She's their flag bearer tonight. She's 26 years of age. She's got a world ranking now. She's just had a fantastic tour through Asia, and she's down here to defend her three gold medals, which she won at the last game. She won the women's singles, she won the mixed doubles, and she won the doubles as well, and she's out to do the same again.
You know, American Samoa, the flag bearers for each country's, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to acknowledge the Ministry of Education, Sports and Culture, the beautiful women and men who are in the traditional tatau or the traditional tattoo, which is the malu and the tattoo, the pea. They are leading each delegation into Apia Park. So malo lava to the ministry.
Population just under 57,000. They dominated in women's basketball of Papua New Guinea in 2015. They won 3 gold medals. And it was just a hop, skip and a jump from the American Samoa team to come across here to Apia.
Welcome, American Samoa.
Indeed, and as you said, Ken, 16 sports this time around as well as athletics. They're in basketball. They're in boxing as
We'll be heading to Savai'i.
Indeed it will.
So make sure you book the boat to go across.
In the second week. And there's a bit of a Fiji connection here as well, because I believe that Anesi Saravai is backing up, and she's part of the American Samoan netball team as well. So a little bit of a connection there with Fiji. Here are the Aussies.
Oh, you're
a powerful
Aussie,
impact.
Aussie, Aussie.
Second time only in the Pacific Games. They were debuting back in 2015, Ken.
Wonderful.
In support of Pacific, not only sport, but business and other development programs over a long period of time, especially through the AusAid program, has meant that they have had a footprint in the Pacific and have been part of the Pacific for a very long time. It's an increased size team from Australia. Wonderful to see them here. Looking forward to them competing.
58 athletes this time from Aussie and Apia. This time round, they'll be competing in athletics. Watch out for them in athletics, because they're up and after some Grand Prix points to try and qualify for Tokyo, the 2020 Olympic Games. Beach volleyball, rugby seven, sailing, weightlifting, and taekwondo. The team from Australia, small but very, very powerful. Part of the expansion, of course, of the games concept here. Here's the beautiful Cook Islands, all the way from the eastern side of the Pacific.
Kia ora.
They're very popular, the Cook Islands. We talk about tiny nations in our Pacific, 18,000 population. They won 6 gold medals at Papua New Guinea in 2015. They too have brought an increased team to these games in 2019. Their rise in rugby union and especially in rugby league in recent times has been terrific. And of course their netball team has always been a strong feature of sport in the Pacific. Kia rana, the Cook Islands.
Yeah, 15 codes from the Cooks this time round. Athletics, basketball, as you said, football, golf, lawn bowls as well, Ken. And also speaking of lawn bowls, Royden Apero, who will be apparently one of the youngest lawn bowlers here, is supposed to be a real gun. So we'll be keeping an eye out for young Royden in the competition here, lawn bowls. 200 athletes, as you said, Ken, a big performance from the Cooks last time. They're very excited. Consequently, the big commitment here to this time round.
Just like to acknowledge the teams, not forgetting the young students' participation. The school, the primary schools in the country are also taking part. They are bearing the names of each of the delegations. So there's a head boy and head girls of Vaivasya Primary School that is representing Cook Islands. Thank you for your participation, and we will be seeing more students later on in the evening.
We will indeed, and it's fantastic. Just the commitment, the general commitment from Samoa here through all strata of society to get these games up and happening within 17 months has been quite incredible. And to see the Cookies here, what a delight.
One of the features of our short time since being here in Samoa is watching how the villages and the schools have adopted nations. The street front, the village fronts, they look fantastic with the colour. We talk all the time about the spectacle, and what a fantastic concept to commit young people, as Verona has alluded to, to be part of nations that are participating.
And it's not just in Upolu, all the islands of Samoa.
Federated States of Micronesia, of course, up there in that northwestern side of the Pacific, and traditionally a powerhouse in weightlifting. But one of their great champions, Benoit Mingenfeld, has retired since he took 3 golds out of Papua New Guinea 4 years ago. Going to be interesting to see how the FSM goes this time.
Yes, they were 3 indeed. Stunning gold medals. Just a population of 103,000 in Federated States of Micronesia, and those 3 gold medals, one in Papua New Guinea. It was a cause of great celebration, not only in the Federated States of Micronesia, but across the Pacific and, of course, the weightlifting world.
As you can see, a beautiful evening here in Apia. The sun has set. We had some showers early, but the Weather Bureau has got it absolutely right. They've lightened up. There's a beautiful breeze just blowing gently across Apia Park. We're a little bit worried about the impact on the kids, but they're out here. They're loving it.
They're loving it. every single minute of it. And now, come rain or shine, I think that's where Samoa's spirit comes through in every single thing. Whatever challenge, obstacle, they override it. And I think that comes from great leadership. Bula to Fiji Islands.
Nissan Bula Vinaka indeed to very, very popular Fiji. Just under 900,000 population. They've sent in a team over 400 to this year's games. They were the second most gold medal winning country in 2015 at Papua New Guinea, winning 33 gold. They are well represented and they are very, very popular members of these specific games and are expected to be dominant in a majority of sports.
Well, they are indeed. 26 teams, in fact, representing Fiji, 395 athletes exactly, and 460 athletes and officials. Chef de mission is Patrick Bauer. Nice. The team's motto, one in spirit. They are a powerhouse. The other interesting thing, guys, is that ahead of it, they've also decided to get into some PNG team funding as well, big-time funding into the Fiji team. Wow. And it's certainly bearing dividends.
Well, welcome to Samoa. Your stamina, your spirit will be on display at the various sports that you'll be representing Fiji with. So good luck.
Of course, they are the defending Olympic gold medalists from Rio de Janeiro in 2016. They have sent a very strong sevens team to compete in the sevens tournament starting later this week.
We'd like to welcome to the stadium Hafadai Guam. We have our young lads there in the national wear of Guam, Jamer Atonio and Ete Yang Tong of St. John's Primary School.
150 athletes, coaches and team managers, and absolutely dominant in the Northern Pacific. They absolutely smashed it at the micro games up in Yap last year. 26 golds, 12 silvers and 12 bronze medals up there.
Wow.
But they're going to be up against it down here in the Central Pacific in the heart of Polynesia.
Basketball and volleyball are expected to feature as they did in Papua New Guinea.
They did indeed. In fact, they're defending gold medals, aren't they, Ken? And they went on after that and they took out the FIBA East Asian Championships as well. And they really are backing themselves in here for a couple of gold medal finishes. They want that because they want the FIBA ranking points to go through into the big FIBA competitions later on next year.
Wonderful atmosphere in here at Apia Park. As I said earlier, Brendan and I blessed to be here in 2007 as we welcome in Kiribati.
One of the great powerhouses of weightlifting, adjacent to Nauru in the center of the Pacific, part of Micronesia as well. The Kiribati team has got some super weightlifters. None of them are out there tonight, so I think they're going to take this competition very seriously.
Samoa is also one of their challengers for the gold medals in the weightlifting, so all the best.
Yeah, it's one of the feature sports in the Pacific. The growth over the last couple of decades of weightlifting, Brendan, has been nothing short of sensational.
And David Catatua, one of their super heavies, going to be going this week as well. He is a UN ambassador as well for climate change. He is absolutely committed to addressing the whole issue of rising sea levels, particularly around Kiribati, which he says is having a profound impact on his people. On again into Micronesia, up now to Marshall Islands.
Yes, we welcome and extend a warm yawe to our athletes and officials from the Marshall Islands. In national wear, we have Puli Teofilo and Etewati Kome of Levi Salimor Primary School.
Yeah, they won 5 bronze medals at Papua New Guinea. The Marshall Islands, only a small country, about 50,000. Teams here who achieve outstanding given the size of the populations they represent.
But thinking again about sea levels and so on, Marshalls will be hosting the 2022 Micro Games and recently had a groundbreaking ceremony for their new athletics track at Genrock Village near Majuro. Now this is also going to be acting as a seawall against rising waters as well, and so it's going to double not only as a wonderful facility but also a seawall against rising waters.
I think this is the Pacific Games, as you will know, Glenn and Ken, this has been the entire one of the theme is greening Samoa, so that has been this will be very good and tie in to that.
Talking about the epicentre of weightlifting in Micronesia, Nauru is one of the guns. It all started back in 1990 with the mighty Marcus Stephen and the combination with Paul Coffer, which was, of course, the embryonic creation of the Oceania Weightlifting Centre and Institute, now based in New Caledonia. But boy, oh boy, does it, this little country have a story to tell, Ken.
Exactly. Only 10,000 people. They won 7 gold medals. Weightlifting and judo is where they're expected to feature strongly in 2019. And this, the 16th Pacific Games.
And now to one of the powerhouses of Pacific sport. This is New Caledonia, which in the editions of these Pacific Games, 16 editions, it has dominated 12 of them. Part of an affiliation with Metropolitan France, it means that their top athletes do get top French and European training and coaching, and boy, does the Pacific really enjoy that.
Well, bonjour, New Caledonia, and all the best during the Pacific Games.
60 medals in Papua New Guinea, population just under 300,000. French is the spoken language. Very popular, very cosmopolitan representative of the Pacific, New Caledonia.
And one of the Kanaka warriors there just putting out a challenge. I think we're going to be seeing a little bit more of this as the night goes on. Part of the colour and the spectacle and the culture of this beautiful part of the world that we call the Pacific
Honestly,
Ocean.
Honestly, it's not just the sport. This is what this Pacific Games is all about. And the display of culture will be so diverse, not just tonight, but over the next 14 days.
1966, 1987, and 2011, the 3 years that New Caledonia have hosted the Pacific Games.
We're talking about the ability of the picked up 11 gold medals in PNG.
Wow.
She's not here because she's swimming the European Championships.
Well, our Pacific people are swimming all four corners of the earth, and just to display, not just in the Pacific, but all corners of the world, that is, their talent.
But guess what?
What?
They've found an alternative to Laura, and her name is Emma Trebo. She picked up 6 gold medals in the pool in Papua New Guinea,
amazing.
And she's here this time as well. She will be the new Laurent. Let's just enjoy the Kanaka warrior here as he goes through his moves.
He's popular, colourful, and charismatic. Countries that represent the Pacific, where our opening ceremony sometimes resemble a closing ceremony with the colour and the laughter. Great scenes and great atmosphere here at Apia Park.
I reckon this delegation makes up the more than 5,000 in athletes and all the visitors that are the delegates that are in the country for the Pacific Games, and making this Pacific Games the biggest and probably the biggest game ever. Over 5,000 athletes and team officials competing in Samoa. We say Malo Lava. This has been a huge challenge that Samoa has risen up to, and we congratulate the organizing committee of the Pacific Games for pulling this together.
Wonderful scenes here. The New Caledonia team celebrating their arrival at the Pacific Games 2019.
Team from New Caledonia and the Kanak Warriors really beginning to stir them up here in Samoa.
Oh, I think it just makes up for the rain over the last few days. Don't you think, Brendan?
It certainly does. It's a wonderful evening.
Now let's welcome our friends from the land of the long white cloud, New Zealand.
Kia ora, New Zealand. And New Zealand supporters, wherever you're watching around the world. Like Australia, have had a very strong influence around the Pacific with the NZA program, sport, business and development projects that they have supported over a long period of time.
Very big boy there, as you can see, a demonstration of pure power, because that's their Commonwealth champion, Mr. Liddy himself. He will be in action in probably one of the most exciting weightlifting events a little bit later this week. Can't wait to see Mr. Liddy. He was throwing truck tires around this week down in Auckland before he came out here as a demonstration of his power. But there are others in this team as well we should be looking out for, Ken.
Looks like we've got a haka coming up from the New Zealanders.
Sevens captain Samoan himself, BJ Forbes, part of the New Zealand team, a legend of the Sevens game.
This field is Mr. Forbes is no stranger to the rugby fields. Ken, in the past, he's represented New Zealand in many of the games that they've faced Samoa in the past.
Niue then, the Rock. In the Central Pacific, expecting 8 sports here from them this time around: boxing, golf, lawn bowls, netball, powerlifting, and rugby nines as well. And Ken, you'll be doing a little bit of rugby nines.
Yes, looking forward to having them represented in the nines. The majority of the Niue population, as we know, live outside the Rock, outside Niue, mainly in Sydney, Australia, and in Auckland, New Zealand. They are well represented this year in 2019. Looking forward to their progress over the course of our games.
Also going to be seeing a couple of new ends in action down at the weightlifting as well. They have a pretty proud tradition there, and have ended up with a couple of medals as well from the Commonwealth Games.
Primary school wearing the national wear of Niue.
Beautiful Apia Park, one of the most famous...
All the stadiums are filled up, Brendan.
One of the most famous venues in the Pacific. And here we now welcome Norfolk Island to this opening ceremony.
Wearing the national wear of Norfolk Island is Whamalu Whamanu Whafowina and Whauwa'ai of Samatauta Primary School.
Well, population just under 1,800, won 2 gold medals, have featured heavily in bowls in 2015 in Port Moresby.
6 sports this time round: archery, golf, lawn bowls, as you mentioned, Ken, netball, shooting, and squash this time round as well. Norfolk Island were hosts back in 2001 of the mini games. And on then up into Micronesia again, as we welcome Northern Mariana Islands.
And we have the children from the Apolima Primary School, our small little island there. And they all travelled to the Pier Park to represent the Mariana Islands.
To be host of the next mini games in a couple of years' time, really knocked around very badly by Typhoon Uta some 6 months or so ago, has really knocked the bottom out of the economy up there. Again, we're talking about the environment and the impact of global warming. These guys up there would probably be able to acknowledge that with a devastating typhoon up there.
Yes, with a population, we have populations in these tiny countries the size of suburbs in some of our more developed countries, and as Brendan alluded to, they deal with the reality of climate change and global warming, and now the beautiful island of Palau.
Indeed, Palau once again up in Micronesia. 7 sports this time around as well: archery, athletics, judo, va, swimming, table tennis, and volleyball. That's beach volleyball, one of Ken's specializations.
1 silver and 1 bronze in Port Moresby in 2015. Population of just 21,000 in Palau. Wonderful to see them here again in 2019.
Again, a bit of a powerhouse up there in Micronesia, certainly in track and field, but they're going to be really tested down here, as we were saying, against some of the top competition like Papua New Guinea, Fiji, New Zealand and Australia. It's a division again, but they're there, and they're thereabouts, Palau. Going to be very interested to see how they go over the next few days of competition here at the Pacific Games.
Well, wishing you all the best to the athletes from the 500 islands of Palau. I think coming up next, we have Solomon Islands.
Well, there's a lot of excitement, Brendan, around Solomon Islands, who will host the Pacific Games in 2023. Their delegation representing those games are here en masse. And we are very excited at the conclusion of these games to be heading to Honiara, where Solomon Islands, for the first time in its history, will host the Pacific Games.
Yes, it's a big responsibility, and there's a big statement here by Solos. They've put in a big team here. 22
Congratulations,
sports.
Solomon Islands. And we will be happy to hand over the organization of the next games coming up. And Samoa will only know, we can only share the experience that they've gone through in the past 17 months to our friends in the Solomon Islands.
Well, seven gold medals in the Port Moresby in 2015, a population just under 700,000. We are excited at the prospect of going to the Solomon Islands in 2023.
And I tell you what, the Melanesian Brotherhood is strong as well, because PNG also going to help underwrite and get involved in some of the administration and assist them as well, and give them the benefit of their 2015 experiences as well. And likewise, I guess Samoa obviously going to help as well.
We are brothers of the Pacific, and we'll be more than happy to help each other out. I mean, look, this is probably one of the biggest events that can bring all nations of the Pacific together. And why not? The diversity in culture, the environment, what we're fighting for, climate change, and the vulnerabilities of each Pacific island. Despite all that, the resilience is displayed here tonight. They come in numbers, not just tens, in the hundreds. Look at Tahiti. They're right here. Bonjour and yorana to the delegation of the French Polynesia, Tahiti.
Once again, another one of the powerhouses, this time from the eastern side of Polynesia. Of course, the Tahitians, they've got 21 sports here this time round. They finished third on the medal table last time, back in 2015. They're there or thereabouts, the Tahitians.
They have twice hosted the Pacific Games in 1971 and 1995. Tahiti, hugely popular country around the Pacific, Tahiti.
And also watch out for them in Va'a. They are the world champions, and they're probably put on a massive demonstration in most of the categories here. They are absolutely prodigious in Va'a.
All the best to you. I believe Samoa and all the other nations of the Pacific that are here will be vying for the top three positions. And I'm pretty sure Bren and my friend Ken here have got their selection and their picks of the Pacific Islands in the top three.
Well, we do indeed. In 95, of course, it was Tahiti that put on a very memorable Pacific Games. It was absolutely phenomenal what the Tahitians did back then. And as I say, underwrites a very strong commitment to sport in that part of the world. Very powerful team. And we're going to be seeing them medal a lot here in Apia at this 16th edition of the Pacific Games.
The weather has been good for us. The images you can see wherever you're watching around the world from Apia Park in Samoa, the opening ceremony of the 2019 Pacific Games. There's an electric atmosphere here. Yeah. And I something that Samoa can share and celebrate with the world.
You know, in the 17 months, we've undergone a lot of construction for all the constructions around the Pacific, around Samoa, just to get this Games underway. And I think the last few days of rain is a cleansing process from above to help us freshen and depict all these beautiful colors that you see on screen tonight.
Looks like the Tahitians are going to organize themselves into a haka.
They share their culture, they share their language, and they share their passion with us, Tahiti.
They're making a very strong statement in that very strong red.
And if you're joining us for the first time ever watching a Pacific Games opening ceremony, this is part of the tradition that the various groups from across the Pacific will throw out a challenge and organize themselves into hakas like this and challenge out and welcome the various teams with a routine like this.
Yes, of course, they have their own countries, leaders, political leaders, community and business leaders who are in the official part as well.
I would say not so much a challenge, but also a blessing for everybody that's here. And, you know, this is their way of expressing their excitement to be landing here safely and being accommodated, you know, in a very good place out at Faleula, where activity is buzzing. There's been training every day.
finished third at the 2015 Pacific Games, Tahiti, with 39 gold medals, 34 silver and 41 bronze.
Football, boxing, basketball, among their traditional features, and rugby union, it has been interesting watching their progress in recent years, Tahiti.
Well, they're definitely coming in, not coming in lightly to the Pacific Games this year.
Well, they've certainly announced their arrival, haven't they? Tahiti, and as we were saying,
welcome
a big
to
team,
Samoa.
21 sports, and so to one of the smaller delegations from Tokelau.
Maloni to the athletes and delegates of Tokelau.
Six sports this time round.
One athlete. In 2015, representing the Tokelau, they've sent a team in 2019, and we are looking forward to their increased participation
in judo, lawn bowls, netball, va'a, rugby nines, and touch this time round, Ken.
It's very exciting to see the Tokelau Islands represented so strongly at these games in 2019. I know that across the Pacific they are celebrating the Honourable Chris Farfoy, Member of Parliament and Minister in New Zealand, who has been elevated to Cabinet. And him, Chris and his family will be watching proudly as this Tokelau Island take their place at the Pacific Games in 2019.
And speaking, Brendan, of climate change, this is one island that is very, very vulnerable. It was predicted back 10 years ago that it will be under 20 feet of water due to climate changes. But look, they've arrived. They are still here.
Well, the breakdown of coral, the increased rising temperatures and sea levels, the pressure that it places on our islands and on our people, especially around the Pacific. We are here to celebrate, but there are some very sobering and some realistic challenges that a number of our smaller nations across the Pacific face in the next little while.
Well, they might be small, but let's see how loud they can get.
Population in the Tokelau, majority of these athletes from New Zealand and from Australia, large populations in Auckland, Wellington, Porirua and Sydney, Australia. And wonderful that they have been able to find the resources to make coming here a reality in 2019.
Well, what a night it is here. The occasion, we're live, we're in the heart of Polynesia, and here is one of the great Polynesian countries entering the stage now.
We say malolele to the Kingdom of Tonga, to your delegates, to your athletes. Welcome, Talofalava. Welcome to Samoa.
Well, they are a very special country in the Pacific, the Kingdom of Tonga. Malolele. And we talk about Pacific athletes, and in particular the rise of the Tongan athlete in the last 10 years. 70 Pacific Island players in the NFL, 8 in the NBA, 13 Pacific players in the Wallabies, 19 in the latest All Black team that has been selected. The increase and rise of the Pacific Island athlete is no better illustrated than the Kingdom of Tonga, who are here this year.
And there's another great Tongan athlete as well, the great Pai Wolfgram, got all the way through to the heavyweight final in Atlanta. Silver medalist and Olympian, and what a mighty champion. And a very warm welcome to you this evening, Pai, if you are watching these pictures.
Yes, he was part of our commentary team in 2015. Pai Wolfgram, Benny Pike, was back leading our boxing commentary in 2019. Asinate Oingolo is also here from Fiji. Willie Lose from Tonga. Richard Hewitt from Australia. He is part of the commentary team at the 2019 Pacific Games.
Well, a warm welcome to our friends from Tuvalu. Malo Lava, we are like to acknowledge Suluia Vaipuna of Samatau Primary School, who are wearing the national wear of Tuvalu, leading the delegation right there.
Tiny Tuvalu, who travelled to Apia by boat to compete at this year's games. Small, popular.
In the 21st century, we are still navigators, and we still use our canoes to travel the oceans and to land successfully. Welcome to Samoa.
They'll be competing in 9 sports this time round as well, including athletics, boxing, football, powerlifting, rugby sevens. They've got a team in the sevens this time round, table tennis, beach volleyball, indoor and also indoor volleyball, and also weightlifting.
And of course, not forgetting the Republic of Vanuatu, we do have a very big delegation there of athletes and officials who have made it all the way to Samoa.
2015, the Vanuatu team won 2 gold medals, karate and beach volleyball. And they will be a very strong contender in 2019.
And they will indeed. Of course, they went on to host the mini games 2 years after that, did extremely well at home. And also the impact there of a number of Chinese coaches as well on the Vanuatu teams saw them produce some extraordinary performances. We're expecting to see more of that this time round as well. Going to be very handy in track and field here and other sports as well.
Yeah, 2017, Port Vila was the host city for the South Pacific Mini Games. And congratulations to Vanuatu, that was well organized. And a wonderful experience for all of us that were part of those mini games.
And for those of joining us internationally who might not be aware of the Pacific Games concept, the Pacific Games here is a multi-sport event, but for the smaller nations of the Pacific, an opportunity to host smaller events, up to 12 sports every 2 years and alternate years to the main games. It was Vanuatu's turn last time round. They did a super job, as Ken said, and they've benefited from it in terms of sports administration and athletic performance, and we'll see the benefits of that this time in Apia.
I think there's been a lot of learning lessons taken from our friends from Vanuatu that Samoa has taken up for its athletes and their training, as well as preparation towards the Pacific Games this year.
Lovely to see Wallace and Fortuna here again, 1 gold medal in Papua New Guinea in 2015. They've sent a reasonably sized team, have been very competitive in some of the team sports.
Track and field as well, very powerful in track and field, and they've got a very powerful track and field team here as well, concentrating more on the field sports. And the great Lakafia from a number of years ago, the great Wolusian javelin thrower, went on to the world stage. That was a couple of years ago, but more of that probably this week here in Apia as well. 5 sports this time round. Athletics, as I say, will be strongly represented. Va'a as well, and they'll also be fielding teams in rugby sevens, volleyball, and weightlifting.
Brendan, the delegation is majority is women, I believe.
Indeed, but in track and field, it's exclusively men.
Yep. Oh, I see.
And as the tension begins to mount here, Ken.
Yes, we are awaiting the arrival of the host nation as we acknowledge Wallace and Fortuna, their team, their arrival and their participation in these games. And what an experience it has been already for us to be here alongside these Pacific nations.
Got a feeling that the Wolusians will probably throw down a bit of a challenge here. Usually they do. Let's see whether they're going to organize themselves this time round.
Well, why not? This is their moment. Let's see it.
Yeah, 1 gold medal, Papua New Guinea. Population just under 12,000.
Again, hosted a mini games a few years ago, French speaking.
And now they will share some of their culture and some of their country's legacy with us, Wallace and Fortuna.
There's a lot of similarities in the movements of all the Pacific Island dancers, you know, but one thing that's common that is so unique is the smile and the friendliness that comes through in their performances. So well done, Wallace and Fortuna.
Wonderful, Wallace and Fortuna. We are looking forward to them across a host of sports. Very popular. Whakapapa to Samoa. Samoa is founded on God. This is a very special moment, a very special highlight in this year's games.
Indeed. The very proud nation of Samoa is represented with over 500 athletes who are making their way now to the front of the stadium. The host of the 16th Pacific Games in 17 months, they have produced the miracle that it is tonight.
It's incredible. As we were saying earlier on, there would be few countries in the Pacific that would be able to pull something like this off. But it's a legacy, I guess, of the last time that they hosted the Games, that they're able to use again the fantastic facilities that were built for 2007, put them to good use. The Prime Minister and sports, there he is in picture, getting behind the momentum, the machine that is sport in this country, to invite and get the rest of the Pacific after Tonga decided that it could not, for financial reasons, go ahead with this edition.
We always rise to the occasion, Brendan, and I think this is proof of it tonight, seeing the participation not just from the athletes that will be performing over the next couple of weeks, but the nation as a whole.
17 gold medals in Papua New Guinea. They are expected to feature heavily at their own games. And after Brendan alluded to the decision by the Kingdom of Tonga to withdraw from the games, and Samoa stepping up at short notice, and we look at the spectacle that they have delivered already on this opening ceremony, a little over 45 minutes long, and it is wonderful weightlifting. Brendan, they have made some serious strides in some world-class sports.
Absolutely, and as far as weightlifting is concerned, we're going to see some junior world record holders right here. Junior world record holders, Commonwealth champions as well. The team that is weightlifting in this country under Jerry Warwick has been quite phenomenal.
One of Samoa's favourite athletes, Beatrice Famuina, Commonwealth gold medalist in the discus.
You saw the emotion in her eyes there, and I really do think that these crowds are going to lift this team big time. When Samoa travels, interestingly, over the last few years, I haven't seen them get much better than about fifth or sixth on the medal tally. Every time they host a medal here, look at the passion and the emotion in those eyes. Every time they perform here in front of their own people, they are up either second or third. Watch out for Samoa this time round. I think we're going to see some legendary performances.
Absolutely.
We're talking about a country with a population that's on 200,000 and the impact that they have, not only in sport, but in the performing arts and in education. And wonderful Samoa, what a terrific job they have done in a very short period of time. To energize their nation, to create the infrastructure, to create the organization. The volunteer base is enormous here in Samoa for these games, given they are the biggest games in the history of these South Pacific Games. First hosted, of course, in 1963. The work, organization, and passion that this country has shown to deliver a world-class event is exceptional.
I believe the previous record holder was New Caledonia in 2011. With a total of 4,899 athletes and officials that did attend the Pacific Games. So Samoa has upped the game.
Well, indeed, we're expecting the official announcement probably in the next little while. We might be breaking some news here, I think, but it looks likely that Samoa has gone very close to, if not over, that 5,000 mark, which is the first time ever in their history of Pacific sport that that many athletes have been gathered in one place.
I believe there's still more that have yet to arrive in the country, Brendan.
Indeed, I believe there's a contingent of sailors coming in from the eastern side of the Pacific, which will swell numbers even further.
Of course, Samoa is expected to feature in archery.
Oh, and none other than our very own leader.
With the defending silver medalist.
Honourable Prime Minister Tulefa Sailele Malielengoi. The leadership of this man to have, you know, the bravery to take up the games and prepare it in under 17 months is nothing less of a miracle.
Yes, he did. Well, I talked to him about his involvement in the archery, and he said it was deliberate to create interest in the sport, and then hopefully that the attention as a result would encourage young people to participate.
Well, you never know, Ken. I might be the next athlete in the next Pacific Games. Watch out.
When they hosted the Games back in 1983, Samoa finished in second place just behind the New Caledonians. When they hosted the Games again, they were just one medal away from second place behind New Caledonia and Tahiti. Let's see what they can do this time round.
Standing room only. You wouldn't believe the rain that we were dealing with 2 hours ago, and the weather. Somebody is shining a light of kindness on our opening ceremony.
Well, we pray that this will continue over the next 14 days of the Pacific Games, the 16th Pacific Games.
Mr. Gordon.
We've got the Manu Samoa team that will be presenting the delegates and officials and everybody here in the stadium.
Pretty famous shot there, I thought, of a very famous coach, just a glimpse.
The most decorated coach in World Sevens rugby, multiple winner of the HSBC Sevens Series and a World Cup champion. There he is at the back. The great Sir Gordon Titchens has given his time and energy in recent times to the Manu Samoa team, who will perform the Sivatau. Tomasi Alosio will captain the Manu Samoa Sevens team. They have picked a very strong side to compete in these South Pacific Games, as have Fiji. That will be one of the features, as it always is, in the Sevens, Fiji and Samoa.
Well, there's also going to be a fantastic showdown in the 100 metres as well, because you've got Mr. Dodson representing Samoa going up against Mr. Banuve from Fiji, the men's 100 metres. If you're talking about showdown, Samoa-Fiji, Ken, because in the second week of competition, boy, have we got a 100 metres. Plus, we've got the Aussies and the Kiwis in there looking for Grand Prix points as well. The men's 100, awesome.
There are scenes of emotion again. Beatrice Famoina summing it up for a lot of us, just what it means to the people of Samoa to be hosting these games, even allowing for the circumstances in which it occurred.
This is a huge team here. It underwrites the massive contribution that Samoa's made in hosting this event. And I tell you, they are going to be represented across all of the sports.
No, Brendan and Ken, you know, as per the Constitution, you know, Samoa is founded on God, and these games have been built around our faith in God and our belief and trust in our people, that as Samoans, we will rise to the occasion and make these games a reality. Now, we don't know the financial impact, which is not yet known, but hopefully it'll be something that'll be revealed later on after the games. But there are also teams from different institutions carrying out surveys during the game for the purpose of compiling an impact report, which I think it's quite impactful already. But I think one of the key pillars of the PGO is to invest back into our local economy, build the capacity of our local service providers, and use this opportunity to promote Samoa to the world. And all the benefits, therefore, will not be immediate, but I'd say hats off to Samoa. And, you know, for all the broadcasters that have come together to make this a reality, not just for Samoa Broadcasting, but to all the countries around the world, we have some new stations that have come on board, right, Brendan?
Indeed, yes. It's a very large audience that we're broadcasting to, and it's a very warm welcome to us here. Maybe in the next week or so, you'll get to see and feel some of the magic that is the Pacific Games. It's a unique event. It's been running, as Ken said, since the early 1960s, 63 when first hosted the first of those Pacific Games. It's been growing in size and magnitude ever since, and this in fact, it looks like Australia and New Zealand will probably be added in a permanent sense to be able to field a couple of teams. Not all of them, because they don't want the bigger countries in our part of the world dominating athletic competition. But certainly they will become permanent members.
Well, 2007, there was a multi-million dollar investment to build the infrastructure. And one of the downsides of spending so much money on infrastructure with Commonwealth Games, Pacific Games, Olympic Games are held is what use of that infrastructure and facilities can they make. Samoa presented with this opportunity with Tonga withdrawing less than 2 years ahead of today's opening ceremony. They're able to use those facilities again. Some of them have been significantly upgraded. And when these games finish in 2.5 weeks' time, there will be some lovely facilities that are going to be left for the people of Samoa and other events that they will host in the future.
Absolutely. Recently, the Apia Park Stadium was flooded in a recent cyclone. And so the netball stadium was, netball teams around the country were out for a while. So this is the recent multi-complex at Faleata is one huge development that will definitely help advance netball, volleyball, and all the indoor games.
Well, this first venue here in the heart of Polynesia, Apia Park, tonight, the venue for the opening ceremony of these 16th Pacific Games.
Yeah, nearly 5,000 athletes are still inside the stadium tonight. There are still some others to arrive in the next few days that are in competition next weekend, which will tip the official participation mark for this year's Olympic Pacific Games to over 5,000. Of the period of uncertainty 17 months ago to where we are today, it is indeed a grand occasion for Pacific sport.
Very shortly, to all our viewers around the world, you will be witnessing the parade for the ceremonial flag, and we have some very prominent people in the community that will be bearing the ceremonial flag, the 16th Pacific Games 2019. On your right there, you'll see gentlemen, to your right, we have the chef de mission for Team Samoa to the Vanuatu Mini Games in 1993. She is the long-serving president of Samoa Netball Association and sport administrator, also a former board member of SASNOC, none other than Pesita Nomesimi. Also on her right, just behind Pesita, is Dawn Rasmussen. She had represented Samoa at the 5th Sub-Pacific Games since 1963. Represented Samoa in athletics, hockey, netball, and tennis. She is the first physical education teacher in Samoa and trained physical education teachers at the Western Samoa Teachers Game in 2016. She is Dawn Rasmussen. And behind Dawn, we have Manuia Porter. She is the lead in lawn bowling. And just on the right side, we have Tuatangaloa Joe Annandale. He is the co-owner of Sinalei Reef Resort. founding president of Va'ai Laufoi Club when Va'a was first introduced in Samoa, world sprints in Honolulu in 1989, and he was in the men's number one team and competed in the Open's 500 meters and 1500 meters. Just behind Tuatanga Loa and Ndeo, we have Michael Kapisi. He represented Samoa in hockey in 1979, golf in 1993, a member of the Samoa Rugby 15s team 1978-1979. And the third gentleman bearing the flag is Masoe Norman Witzel. In 1981, between 1981 to 2009, he was the squash national representative, a national champion 1991-1999, Samoa Games gold medalist in 94, men's double silver medalist. He's a medalist owner back in the days, but still involved and been heavily involved in the Pacific Games organization thus far. He does wear many hats in the private sector, and absolutely amazing to see this generation empowering the younger generation that are this part of this that are part of this year's Pacific Games.
So the official flag then of the Pacific Games now flies high over Apia Park here. Rain earlier, but now staying away. You can see just this beautiful breeze just lifting the flag a little bit here at Apia Park.
The spirit is flowing indeed, right here at Apia Park, at the grand opening ceremony of the 16th Pacific Games 2019 in Apia, Samoa. Wherever you're tuning in, from Samoa or around the world, talofa and welcome.
Thank you. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we invite
Well, I think if we reflect on the forefathers of Samoa and the forefathers of the Pacific and these images, as Verona said, wherever you're watching around the world, up here, Samoa, who would have thought that countries of this size, just on 200,000 population, not a big economy, certainly not a big GDP, and what they're able to do with the spirit of the people.
These are the athletes just making their way off the main area now, and the athlete's oath.
We have Steffi Carruthers. She is the star in tennis from Samoa, taking the oath of athletes. And the gentleman's voice that you
I represent all technical officials. We declare that we are officiating the Pacific Games 2019 very sportsmanship, recognizing the rules that govern them, desirous in participating in them.
We have Leatawa Isikuki Punivalu taking the oath for the officials, the athletes, and the technical team.
So the ceremonial flag now is flying high above Apia Park. There are two oath takers there. And now as the athletes make their way off this wonderful stadium, the cultural and ceremonial part of the opening ceremony is about to get underway. There's also, of course, not too far away, the arrival of the flame, which has been carried around the islands.
Very soon you'll be seeing a video of the journey of the torch around the big island of Savai to the small islands of Manono and finally Inupolu. What a journey.
Indeed, and of course two islands will be offering up the games this time round. Upolu, which is the main island here where the majority of the sports will be conducted, but off off island. Savai'i is where the boxing will be taking place.
It is still considered the untouched part of Samoa, Savai'i. So if you're a natural lover, wherever you are in the world, come and see Samoa, especially take the boat ride to Savai'i. Beautiful.
Boxing competition gets underway down there next week. And we will be there bringing you all the action.
A very popular sport in the Pacific, the boxing.
Samoa officially adopted on January 1st, 1962. The symbolic flag displays the white stars of the Southern Cross, blue, saying to represent freedom, red, representative of courage, as well as being a traditional Samoan color.
The famous Reese at work. A few producers around the world with a steady cam underneath that flag. A wonderful image. What a wonderful representation this is of Samoa that we are sending wherever you are around the world. The anthem, the raising of the flag, the presentation on the field.
There are no words sometimes, Brendan and Ken, to describe the feeling and the atmosphere around Apia Park right now. But I think more than 2,000, or maybe close to 2,500 bodies within the stadium is representative of the spirit, as is the logo, one in spirit of the Pacific Games, the 16th Pacific Games, 2019. We have Reverend Faulalolete, the Secretary General of the Methodist Church of Samoa, who is about to bless the games.
I greet you in the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord of the Pacific and the world. The first hymn will be sung by the Ministry of Education.
Tobias, there's another lot of people here. I don't know what they're doing.
Is an opportunity for God's children in the Pacific and the world to meet and unite. Today we have gathered in Samoa and prepared to celebrate God's grace that has made this event possible. This event is also a vessel in which the good news is shown through your attitudes toward each other. And this is why Jesus says in our reading today, to love one another. To love one another is showing good sportsmanship and being respectful towards your fellow sport person. Brothers and sisters in Christ, it is not about winning or losing, but more importantly, that we all shall share the spirit of fellowship and unity amongst us portraying us as specific people of God. I want to leave you tonight and challenge you with the all we can saying of John Wesley. And I believe that this is another good example for us to love one another. Do all good you can, by all the means you can, in all the ways you can, in all the places you can, at all the times you can, to all the people you can, as long as ever you can. May his blessings be upon the Pacific Games of this year. All the best. And may your stay in Samoa be pleasant and peaceful. The special choir will sing the Samoan version of Glory, Glory, Hallelujah.
And delivering the message of hope and blessings for tonight is none other than the Secretary General of the Methodist Church of Samoa, Reverend Faulalo Yeti.
Hallelujah.
Let us pray. All praise and glory to you, our Lord of the Pacific and the entire world, that we have gathered here as a Pacific family to celebrate the love that you have given each and every one of us, that has enabled us to gather together for the purpose of the Pacific Games of this year. We ask that you guide, protect, and keep us. Bless the Pacific Games in every event that will take place. May it be a means of unity for us so we can grow in grace and fellowship as a Pacific family. Bless us with good days throughout this sporting event, and bless our country for hosting such an important occasion, that we may remain respectful towards our brothers and sisters. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
This Church of Samoa. The Secretary General of the Methodist Church of Samoa, Reverend Faulalolete, leading the 16th Pacific Games in Samoa with a blessing, reiterating the message that we are one in spirit. And with that spirit comes respect, leadership, and honoring each other and their talents as we go forth over the next 14 days of display of culture, of talent in sport, creative art, and everything that the Pacific Island people stand for. We welcome the Honorable Tulaepasa Elele Malielengaoi, the Prime Minister of Samoa, for the opening keynote address of the 16th Pacific Games.
Lausunga faulalo leti. Lausunga ileao le malo Samoa. Malau masiofo. Honorable Pacific Sports Ministers. Mr. Vidya Lagan, President of the Pacific Games Council. Afio Minister, Cabinet Masui Minister. And officials, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the government and people of Samoa, I wish to welcome you all, sports people of our blue Pacific continent, and visitors from our 24 Games nations to Samoa, home and host for the 16th Pacific Games. These games will see the Pacific Games return to Samoa for the first time since 2007, and the third overall to be held in Samoa. This month of July in Samoa is known to be dry and sunny. You saw a bit of that hot sun over the last 2 days, which brought many complaints, especially from the archers, who later changed the targets from the west to the north. And so today we have the rain. As host, we will always try
we
acknowledge that this event was initially awarded to Nukol of Tonga. However, the official withdrawal of the Tongan government, for good reasons, from hosting it in May 2017, Samoa this rare opportunity to host such an event. I note that all the teams in 26 sports are here in readiness for competition. These games will see the return of archery and badminton, which were not on the 2015 Pacific Games program. The introduction of an additional discipline for basketball and the potential to set many new records our society. It is therefore pleasing to note that at the conclusion of the sports ministerial meeting held over the past 2 days, Pacific governments and development partners have once again reaffirmed collective commitment to the acceleration of sports development and elite performance across the region. This will only have positive impact across our many island nations. Where excellence is enabled, the role of sport in showcasing national identity and shaping Pacific regionalism is powerful and cannot be understated. Sport has come a long way in the Pacific, and our prowess in boxing, weightlifting, netball, rugby, especially the fast, fury and action-packed sevens, continue to marvel nations globally, many of whom provide support for our peoples to compete internationally. As the Blue Pacific continent, our lifeline resources are the land, our oceans, and healthy peoples. Hence, the importance of physical education, physical activity, sport, a mammoth undertaking, Samoa has used every opportunity to lift the bar and raise awareness on vital issues facing our region. The sporting facilities that we have built for these games are world class, and they will continue to benefit our region for generations. They are a demonstration of the transformative change in train and the new standards that are being set in the Pacific. This is the first Games to commit to a plastic-free event and the first to broadcast around the world in high definition. We could not have accomplished this without the goodwill and dedication of our development partners, such as China, Australia, New Zealand, and regional organizations that have supported our efforts in being games ready within the confines of timeliness. Thank you for your about competitions of the various sports codes. It is all about building people-to-people connectivity and the promotion of sporting activities, as well as a tool to strengthen connections, to enhance understanding of true Pacific regionalism towards peace, development, and genuine love of our neighbors. The Pacific Games should also be a window to demonstrate good governance practices in sport that must rely upon transparent, established, and neutral processes to guarantee legitimacy and fairness, while sporting values can remain essential and properly accounted for. On behalf of Samoa and its people, I wish to thank the organizing committee under the leadership of the Minister of Education, Sports and Culture, Honorable Loau Kenneti Sio, the Pacific Games Office Management Team, and the highly committed sponsors of these games. Very hard over the past 14 months to make this game a success. I would especially applaud the dedication and collective daring spirit of our public service, government, corporations, private sector, and especially our people who have risen to the occasion. You have exceeded all expectations and have now carved our place in history as the largest Pacific Games ever held. But all of these could not have been accomplished without the blessing of the Almighty. Tonight, open the 16th Pacific Games, let us return the praise and thanks to the Almighty God of all nations for providing for our miracle games, without whose help all of this would not have been possible. We are all one in spirit. May you all enjoy the games and have a memorable experience in Samoa. May the best teams and individuals win, and win proud for your countries. O paia falupelupe o le malo, a wā le afio o le ao le malo, le suito Fabele taf tolu, opulenga, the fatawangai, o mamalulavaya fasino, yainga malatutama, Fabele songa to muam puleono, isola fai, tainane, fanononga manu, auno chalale, tulo, ola o tawiana, ole pua ula, o lazy lene tayao ilonga. I tala tū whasorpito o le tātou malo. O le sāili malo lea mō tā longa whavau malo. ia fai mai I o tātou lau whanua ma ele ele sā. O se la sanga mautinoa, e atia e ai le lumanai manuia o whanau e pele I loto o manganga. O se avanoa, whaaulo e atia e ai tā leni tā alo. E whamai te ai le ola whinawhinau I mea e lelei. Ai mai se lava o lo taula mua ai Samoa na mua I malae I le sa ili malo. I le sa ufa ingo malo tau atia e o le continent tele o le vasa pasifika. O talonga o se awala e siseu e se ai loto whanau laiti mua mua manatu e a vanga ngofie I uinga whatupu mala o leo langa whanei ona po. E leo whaanga tama ue hei nei, wa avea mala manuia e tausi ai ainga. O se ngā luenga e tele se le ni emba wai, wa leo toi avea ai o se taanga a tupu langa e whaati teine, Paul Fat Tamai, Ile Mamusa, Oanga Ia, Ole Tosili, Imea Lele, Malam Lo Mai, Leau Faito Fa, Malea Uto Uto Mao Samoa. O ta longa nei o le Pasifika, na tongia ai le malo tonga, lato te tali malo ai. Ina ua lato to e fa mamulu, o le ama no lea na tato la veaia. Aisha, o lo o la pea le la mepa mumu sae sae, o le sa ili malo, na tutu ma faa susulu, e o la toutua a, na mua iasa ina, na ngatsu le tae au fau, ua la tau ta I ai le ala, e na ea soli soli muli, muli a ao ai tu pulanga a muli, lea ua tatu ai ai ai, I le nei tae au na liungalua. E au ai o na mori mori lapa lapa o malo. Le whaafitai lea I le ngā luenga I pūlenga mamalu. I a fionga uma o lo wa teu teu wha mātanga o fie e atu whaalenga ma ai o nuu ma ainga. Ua wha mamale o tota. Ua le talave I whafuatu o Samoa. Ua la tau whapea ne ai o Samoa se atu nuu e tū mamā. Ona tangata e au lele I ona atu whalenga e tau sa fia mā mio pūlea. Ona tangata talabu e le whasua avā. Masona ave sao sao a la tau tavale afi. O le te talo ia tū mau nei winga tau sa fia. Ele ma tau a o tato malo mai fafo. Fa malo foi ya ilato uma ole malo matangata lau tele. Na ofo fua mai lo lato au ananga ya sao e matau le fa moe moe ole atunu. Fa fitai fa pitoa mo a onga a o umalava o lo Iat lato foi siva fa evangelia tainane matua pule aonga ma fai aonga o lou tau sao lea o lou tau o lau tau maa lea ua tongi I le fau sia o le malo o malo Samoa o le fale fau tele fa malo I lau tau tua malo o anga na fa Samoa moni e te mita mita e fai se sao e tau ai lo malo malo watunu. E au o manu o tātou lava singa uma I le alofa tūno le atua o loo whawai ai le malo Samoa. So I fua mai manuia.
The leader of the Samoa nation, Honorable Tula Epa Sailele Malele Ngaoi, delivering the opening keynote address of Samoa 2019 16th Pacific Games, an empowering statement. You know, highlighting some of the opportunities that this Pacific Games has presented for Samoa in taking up the hosting for this year. We now have the remarks by the President of the Pacific Games Council, Mr. Vidya Lakhan.
His Highness, the First Lady, the Honourable Prime Minister of Samoa, and the Deputy Prime Minister, the Chairman of the Games Organising Committee, and Minister for Education, Sport and Culture for Samoa, Cabinet Ministers and Members of Parliament in Samoa, Heads of State of Governments in the Pacific, Your Excellencies, Presidents and Secretary Generals and Officials of the 22 Pacific Games Associations, International Federation Representatives and Oceania Federation's representatives, the very many sponsors and local dignitaries, invited guests, ladies and gentlemen. It is indeed an honor and a real pleasure for me, on behalf of the Pacific Games Council, to extend a very warm Samoan welcome to each one of you gathered here on the occasion of the celebration of the 16th Pacific Games. I accord a very special welcome to the delegations from Australia and New Zealand who are special guests of the Pacific Games Council. Our hosts, the Pacific Games Association of Samoa, under very able leadership of Patrick, the Honourable Prime Minister of Samoa, his cabinet and members of the Samoan Parliament, the members of the Games Organising Committee, have gone to great lengths in preparing for these Games. In less than 18 months, they have done tremendously well. I believe only the Samoans can do it. One of our objectives is to create bonds of kindred, friendship, brotherhood amongst the people of the countries and territories of the Pacific region through sporting exchanges between them, without any distinction to race, gender, religion, and politics. Our challenge is to facilitate for the Pacific community continuing sporting competition in the international sporting arena, whilst preserving our uniqueness and the unity in Pacific values and traditions. I believe in their preparations for these Games, the Samoans have focused on our objective and have very ably met the challenge. The safety, security, and the safety of our athletes have been paramount. What are being delivered in these Games are the result of hard work by the organizing committee, supported by the various stakeholders, international donor governments, and international agencies. We say a very sincere thank you to all of you. Like our host, the Pacific Games Council also believes that the environment being created at these Games will allow participating athletes in their pursuit of excellence to have a unique Samoan experience. I take this opportunity of thanking the various Pacific Island governments, and in particular their sports ministers, for making it possible for their delegations to be present here to participate in the 19th Pacific Games. On behalf of the PANS, on behalf of the Pacific Games Council, I urge all the athletes to be true ambassadors of their respective sports and their respective countries. I urge you all to participate in the Games, in the true spirit of the Games, remembering at all times our Pacific values of friendship, respect, and excellence. Whawhai, thank you.
Vidya Lakhan, who has for many years been overseeing the growth and development of Pacific sport. This is the occasion of the opening ceremony of the Pacific Games here in Apia, Samoa. Pictures coming to you live from this wonderful sporting venue in the heart of Polynesia.
And now to officially declare the 16th Pacific Games 2019 open. Please welcome the head of state.
We have His Highness Tuimalele Fano Valetua Swalaovi the second. On hand now to declare the 16th Pacific Games officially open.
In the holy name of God the Father, God the Son, Jesus Christ, and God the Holy Spirit, I, Tuimalele Fano Valetoa Solawi II, Head of State of Samoa, declare the 16th Pacific Games 2019 open. God bless you all.
And at the highest level, the head of state declares the official Pacific Games, 16th Pacific Games open with a marvelous display of fireworks to honor the official and signaling the end of our formalities for this evening.
Ladies and gentlemen, and that brings our formalities to an end. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Miss Isabella Moore.
Members of the Fiji team there, Patrick Bau, you might see in bottom left of picture, the chef de mission. Very popular and very famous name in Fiji sport, just giving us the thumbs up. Fiji team, a huge team here, looking to go extremely well. Cook Islands there as well. Delegations from around the Pacific, Marshall Islands, and Papua New Guinea, hosts of the last Pacific Games, getting amongst the action here.
Very shortly, we will be hearing from the lovely Miss Isabella Moore, who will be providing the first entertainment of the evening with the operatic number from Puccini.
A very famous voice here in Samoa.
ladies and gentlemen, the beautiful.
Beautiful performance there by Isabella Moore. Put Puccini together with Samoa, the opening ceremony of the Pacific Games, and you have magic.
Sensational. I mean, like I said earlier, Brendan, Ken, this is not just a display of sports over the next 14 days. The creativity of our Pacific Island people, and, you know, as well as those from Samoa, has not only impacted the Pacific region, but the world. She is an opera singer based in New Zealand, but her voice has carried around Europe in the opera world. Coming up next, we have the entertainment from more than 5,000 students. Secondary colleges of Samoa have come together in spirit, one in spirit, for this beautiful display coming to you live on our screens in high definition from Apia, Samoa.
Descendants, voyagers, warriors, mighty Pacific, we come. Our Pacific family, welcome to Samoa.
Ladies and gentlemen, join us in the spirit of the games as we embark on a journey to our history and the voyages that shaped our destiny. This is the story of Leationgye, the boy whose triumph in the ancient combat sport of Aingofie became a legend and won the respect of a nation to this very day. Service is the mark of our respect. Leationgye served his father. He was his provider.
Kaukua wakavela.
He was his protector.
Kaukua koko.
He was his prodigy.
Kaukua kuawai.
The apprentice learning his trade. And he was his father's pride. The marks of our tautua run deep in our blood and inked on our bodies as symbols of service to our elders, to our culture, to our heritage. Like the ancient symbols of the Samoan female tattoo, the malu bears the hallmarks of our service to shelter and to protect. From our service comes our blessings.
Loakali e ye pou liuli lo kingo ye mala mala mau mak ye kafi koko wala.
These are the immortal words of Fitipo to his son Leatunye as he departs to compete in the ancient combat sport of Aingofi. May darkness cover your presence, my son. May the light fall on your enemies and your path marked with their blood. This ancient sport drew warriors from all over Samoa to the three legendary fields of Amota, Amotai, and Muamua. from our blessings, we give you blessings with the Abba, the sacred spirit that binds our Pacific people. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Samoa. Talofa lava.
Sound!
Children from around Samoa have rehearsed diligently over the last few weeks to be able to present to us tonight this cultural festivity here at the opening of the 16th Pacific Games.
Yes, Brendan, they've braved the sun, they've braved the rain, they've braved the winds, and now they're braving the dirt of the grass out there just to bring you a wonderful display of traditional Samoan siva or dance. And also in dance presentation, they are greeting all Pacific nations, both athletes and officials, in the traditional manner, which is the Ava ceremony. So instead, where you usually would have a taupo, you know, presenting the Ava ceremony and conducting that part of the traditional greeting, but it is now displayed by more than 2,000 students. These are various colleges in the country. These are various colleges from around the country, Brendan and Ken, and it's been amazing how the Ministry of Education, Sports and Culture, as well as dance groups, these are protege of the late Alan Alo, who was also key in producing and putting together the opening number for the previous Pacific Games that was also hosted in Samoa not long ago. But tonight, you know, the young people of Samoa, as the Prime Minister had alluded to, this is an opportunity for them to rise and not to gallivant when they come to sporting events such as this. This is an opportunity for them to empower themselves, learn something new, create something new, and be a part of something big and great as the 16th Pacific Games held here in Apia, Samoa. The resilience of these young people, Bryn, is the testimony of that. You know, 7 days into the games, and we've had to call upon a few more, about 500 students, to come in and, you know, be a part of and make up some of the students that were released from the original preparation. But look at that. 7 days to come together, to be in one, in uniformity.
This has been the amazing reaction of these kids and also the games organizers here, that they did have to make amends after, as you said, a number of the kids could not make it here tonight. And as you say, within the last 2 weeks, they've been able to learn this routine, present it here for us tonight. And as you say, great example of the can-do attitude of Samoa. You also explaining as well earlier on, Verona, that a number of the formations that they were creating were reflecting the traditional Samoan tattoo patterns.
Absolutely. Some of the patterns that you would see on a woman's malu or a gentleman's pea were formed on the field just before. And these are symbols of protection, of unity, of coming together as one, and being respectful of each other. These are all the symbols that are representative of these patterns. You know, there's been a lot of talk about the traditional tattoo, and I think the mana of that and the power that comes from having that imprinted on one individual of the Pacific is, you know, a testimony of people's commitment to their own nation, no matter how vulnerable they are to environmental changes, to the challenges and such, the resilience will always come through. Some of the legends that is quite prominent in Samoa, one of that is on display tonight, and it tells of a warrior that prepared, that has had to travel far and to fight the battles in order to find the true leader. And I think that is representative of the Pacific Games, where all nations are coming together. They're all warriors and representative of the Pacific Island nations. They are going to fight the good fight. They are going to honor their challengers, and they are going to respect each other no matter the outcome. So everybody is a winner at the Pacific Games, the 16th Pacific Games.
To seek his destiny was not rewarded by an act of authority, but by an act of faith.
the beautiful Samoan numbers, the songs. If I can interpret it in brief, some of these songs, the story of a voyage of the Samoan people, the Pacific Island people, and how they have fought the many challenges, the many obstacles that they've had to overcome. And the woman warrior there is none other than one of the famous goddesses of our legendary of all times in Samoa, and she is none other than Princess Nafanua. She is known for the battles that she has fought on all four corners of Samoa, whereby she carries the weapons that has enabled future leaders and of the future generations to overcome all these obstacles and challenges. And such is the spirit of the athletes that have come thus far from around the region with their own challenges and the battles that they will have to overcome in order to get that gold medal, that silver medal, that bronze medal. It is all representative in the stories by our ancestors, the journey of our ancestors right up to this point. And overcoming those challenges is welcoming the spirit of Christianity into Samoa, where the faith of every single person in the Pacific nation has been strengthened, where respect has been nurtured, not only from birth, but right through the cultural community. And that spirit has lived on to be able to welcome Christianity into each Pacific Island nation, and to which Samoa is founded on. And there's no better moment than this moment to display that strength, because from there, miracles have been known to happen. And the miracle game has happened because of such faith. So all the glory goes back to the Father. This is the theme of this entertainment tonight. It is called Momoli La'au Fula'a, and it is, in its simplest meaning, giving praise back to the Father, the source of every single thing that Pacific Island nations are founded upon. The greenery of our environment, the beauty of our people, their hearts. To be able to come as one, I think the Pacific region is one of those parts of the world where there's war, there's no war, as you would find in other parts of the world. This is the peace that the Prime Minister has alluded to. This is the respect that the President of the Pacific Games has alluded to. And also the prayer of our church leader this evening. And it is the hope that after tonight, it will live on when the game starts tomorrow, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, until the 21st of July. It needs to be. Otherwise, what are we here for?
And these themes, of course, what makes these games so special and touches all our hearts when we come out here into the Pacific. And I know that Ken alongside us was overwhelmed when he first came out and enjoyed his first Pacific Games back in 2007. And it seems to touch us all. And it's these very poignant moments that moves us and inspires us.
Sam Water, focus of our attention on these games hosted here in Apia, but it's Samoa today who stands on behalf of the 24 Pacific Island nations who are participating, record 5,000 athletes who are here, a record 26 sports. And we heard from the Prime Minister and from the Head of State the acknowledgement and the recognition that God plays in the life of Samoans and in the life of the Pacific. Sunday here in Apia, a deeply sacred and religious day, in the mix of the theme of our presentation, opening ceremony, a reflection of all that is good about being in the Pacific, the challenges that they face. 14 months the Prime Minister referred to, that this great nation had to get ready, the volunteers, the preparation, the planning, and the superb execution on a world-class scale of what we have just witnessed and are witnessing. We make Samoans proud wherever they are around the world.
Brendan and Kenneth, if I, you know, that is such a strong statement. If you may have noticed, the formation is the formation of the Bible. And I think all the words of wisdom that have come out from our leaders tonight, is that is the symbol that they have alluded to. And I hope that all our delegates and officials feel the blessing that has come through with this performance from more than 2,000 students who have been relentless in joining the leaders in putting together this wonderful and sensational performance that you are now able to witness from across the world, wherever you are tuning into. We are broadcasting live from Apia, Samoa, the 16th Pacific Games. You will be seeing a whole lot of display of sports, 24 different sports. But tonight, we give you a piece of Samoa that you will get to enjoy when you do travel to beautiful Samoa someday. There are many airlines that will connect you to our small little island. You will get to travel around Upolu, Pa'i, Manono, Apolima, you name it, we have it. Culture, the food, the entertainment, the people especially, and what they have to offer you in terms of their hospitality and our own Samoan style in anything. You will not find it in Spain, in anywhere in Europe. You will not find it in Australia, or perhaps a bit of Australia and New Zealand have a bit of our culture. But if you want to taste the real thing, to see the real thing, come to beautiful Samoa.
Oh, we all walk in the shadows of those who went before us. We are all products of our history and the legacy that we continue to be a part of in the future. And we're building towards the arrival of the ceremonial torch. And the torch that has its genesis in 1963 in Fiji and has made its way around the Pacific through New Caledonia, three-time host of the Pacific Games, Papua New Guinea, such a wonderful job in 2015, beautiful Tahiti, who have hosted the Pacific Games twice, and the small island of Guam and Samoa for the third time. And the spectacle, the images, beautiful Samoa at its very best, Apia 2019.
If you're watching from wherever you are around the world, you still have 14 days to plan that trip to come over. If you're in New Zealand, we've got Samoa Airways that will bring you directly to Samoa. Very competitive airfares, along with our Air New Zealand as well. We also have Fiji Airways. And there's been some special charters coming around to bring all the delegations and the athletes to the 16th Pacific Games right here in the heart of Apia, Samoa. I must say, Brendan and Ken, I don't know if any athlete that is joining this year's 16 Pacific Games has done more running than this, the more than 3,000 students that are on the field tonight. I feel like I'm out of breath just watching them running all over the field this evening.
Well, the grace and the energy and the culture and the spirit is evident to our viewers taking our coverage around the world.
And the fact that, you know, I have to take my hat off to all the parents of these students. The stadium has been filled over during rehearsals. You know, the drop-off and the pickups, it's amazing. You know, the coordination, you will have one parent that would probably have five children and two of them are participating in this opening ceremony. And yet, they would sit here and tap wai, which is the, you know, the essence of protection, of support.
For some, this tapo'ina is a vibrant, entertaining display of humor and wit through dance and music. The competitor and supporter are equal and essential to the success of any undertaking. Liao Tiongye claimed his victory in the field of Muamua Mua and reigned as one of Samoa's most well-known warriors. His legend is echoed in our oratory and mirrored in our traditions up to this very day. Latin year's story is a true testament of the blessings that are born of service and the mana of our people's spirits that will guide our determination to win. Latin year is revered in our history as the ancestor of the kingly families of Samoa. Pacific Games calls us all to be one in spirit. We are guardians of the blue Pacific. Our home we are now called to save. Navigators of the world's largest ocean. Navigating our way through changing tides and advancing globalization. The Pacific. Our sovereignty and our shared history are at the doorstep of climate change. Arenas the world over. One to stand for our place in the world. One to be seen and be heard. Ladies and gentlemen, this is our time to be one in spirit. Thank you.
Papua New Guinea, Fiji, the Solomon Islands, Vanuatu, New Caledonia, Samoa, Guam, Kiribati, Federated States of Micronesia, Kingdom of Tonga, American Samoa, Bariana, the Marshall Islands, Palau, Cook Islands, Wallace and Futuna, Tuvalu, Nauru, Norfolk Islands, Niue, Tokelau, Pitcairn Islands, Australia and New Zealand. Tonight here at Apia, we are one. Impact of climate change, such a strong message throughout the opening ceremony and the challenges that some of our tiny islands in the Pacific face.
Well, you're right, Ken, because David Katoa from Kiribati, as we were saying earlier on, was the flag bearer tonight, and he continues on in the sport to serve notice that this is a serious problem as far as he and his people are concerned. His own house was washed away in Kiribati recently because of surging sea levels. So images now from around Samoa of the torch relay before its arrival here in the main stadium.
Yes, this was quite an impactful journey, especially for the people of Samoa who were playing host. So, you know, they really rose to the occasion, like Tula'epa had mentioned, and they took ownership, decorated the entire villages, the roads. This is after the launching, the official launching of the torch at the Catholic Cathedral here at Mulivai in Apia. And then they took the torch all the way to the big island of Savai, arrived at the wharf at Salilolonga, covered the far Salileanga district from Salilavalu to Falealupo, and right back. They arrived back into Falatai.
Sense of anticipation now here as we relive some of the highlights, not too far away from the arrival of the torch, and here we see its journey around these beautiful islands.
They adopted, each of the villages also adopted a country, and they decked out their entire school in the, you know, the colors and the traditions of each Pacific Island nations. It's amazing to see. Even the homes of the elderly was visited. This was upon the arrival back of the torch into Opolu. Visited the village of the head of state we've just seen there in Falelatai. And it even traveled by boat to the Manono Island. Do you believe it? Where it was welcomed with open arms by the children. From Leolumuenga village out to Alesa, the Falealili district, and then they had a rest at Taufua Beach Resort in the Lalomanu or Alipata district. Around the town area, Moata'a was covered, the Waimonga district, also Faleata and Leolumuenga. And just yesterday, in the town area, it arrived. And from the front of the government building, it made its journey to the gates of Apia Park, where we see the chief executive officer of the Ministry of Education, Sports and Culture bringing in the torch from the gates of the Apia Park. The team at the Ministry of Education who has been instrumental in putting together this journey and involving so many schools from around Samoa. We have the torch bearers. One of which who will be receiving the torch from the CEO of MISC is Derek Su'a. He is the judo instructor in Samoa, a gold medalist winner of the 100 kgs. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen, the lead, taking the lead of the Ministry of Education, Sports and Culture in Samoa. She has definitely done her best to bring forth education, to empower sports, and definitely highlight Samoa's culture throughout this whole preparation of the Pacific Games, and is on display right here tonight. There you have it, Derek Su'a, qualified for the Rio Olympic Games in 2016, bronze medal winner of the Oceania Champions in New Caledonia 2015, also a bronze of the Oceania Open Continental Games in Samoa in 2014, and he qualified for the Glasgow Commonwealth Games in 2014. Passing on the torch to Matile Sitangata. She is a Samoa Oceania Pacific Games and Junior World Champion in the sport of weightlifting. She has participated in the IPF Junior World Championships, the Oceania Junior Championships, Oceania Open Championships, and the Pacific Games recently in Port Moresby 2015. Kaino Thompson Lotusi of Taekwondo, he is the third Dan Black Belt and instructor. Gold medalist in the 87 kilograms in the South Pacific Games 2007, a London Olympian 2012, Oceania 2012, and a gold medalist of the New Caledonia 2011 Pacific Games.
Great speculation here in Apia all week about who would have the honor of lighting the flame.
Well, it is an honor that is worthy of all the athletes that this torch is bearing. We have there Maureen Tumalelifano of archery, as announced just before. She qualified for the Olympics in Masterton, New Zealand 2011, an Olympian archer in 2012 Olympics in London. Also a silver medalist in the 2000 Pacific Games in New Caledonia. She is the chairman of the Athletes Commission since 2017 and the secretary of the archery since 2012. Well, we look forward to seeing what the archery team have organized, but we certainly look forward to our prime minister himself performing in the archery division. And the man who has made his name in rugby. Rugby Sevens represented the Sevens rugby team, Lolo Lui. He was the captain of the Sevens team from 2009 to 2012. In the Cook Islands Mini Games 2009, he was part of the gold medal team. Also attained gold in the New Caledonia Pacific Games 2011. A cup winner of the IRB Wellington 2007, London 2009, Vegas 2010 and 2012, Adelaide 2010, Hong Kong in 2007 and 2010 in Edinburgh. Certainly a name to be reckoned with, and still behind the scenes of all the rugby development in Samoa. Malolava Lololui. And the name in tennis, Tangifano Denki Sokonolole Sam Chong, also one of the well sought after administrators in Cessnock. She is a 13 gold medal winner, four silver medals. She also attained four silver medals, five bronze medals. And that was attained through the Vanuatu Mini Games in 1993. In 1997, American Samoa Mini Games. I remember this one very well. I attended it and was very honored to be alongside her. 1999 Guam Pacific Games, three gold and one silver. 2001 in Norfolk Island. And Samoa's name, made its name in swimming with Brandon Schuster right there carrying the torch. 400 meter individual medley, middle distance freestyle, middle distance backstroke and breaststroke. He is a scholarship holder of FINA since 2016 and currently holds over 35 national age and open records. He's represented Samoa swimming since 2012, including the 2014 and 2018 Commonwealth Games, the 2015 Pacific and the Rio Olympic Games in 2016. I tell you, history in the making. And ladies and gentlemen, we have our champion in weightlifting, Ele Opelonge, who takes the final leg of the torch towards the cauldron.
And what amazing honor for this particular Samoan athlete, recognized on the world stage. This is a true Olympian.
Absolutely.
A silver medal from the Olympic Games, a prodigious champion, and she lights the flame here in Apia to the roar of this huge crowd here this evening.
A champion worthy of lighting the cauldron. She is a gold winner. Three gold winner of the 2007 Pacific Games here in Samoa. 2008 Olympic Games Beijing, one silver. She won the 2009 Pacific Mini Games in Cook Island. 2010 Commonwealth Games in New Delhi, India. In 2011, she attained three golds at the Pacific Altitude New Caledonia and the Oceania Championship Samoa, where she won three golds in 2012.
And the first female weightlifter from Oceania to ever win an Olympic medal. Ele Opelonge having the honor tonight of lighting this symbol of peace and competition, which will stay alight, of course, for the duration of these 16th Pacific Games, all the way through until the weekend of the 21st.
Well, congratulations to Samoa. The athletes and the officials from representing Pacific Island nations
ladies
that are here in Samoa.
Welcome Miss Agnes Wola and more than 2,000 college students performing our theme song, One in Spirit.
The beautiful Agnes Island Wola presenting and singing the One in Spirit number.
Specially commissioned and written for this occasion.
Absolutely.
And performed publicly for the first time here at the opening ceremony.
Together and unite, and together in
the lovely Agnes Alem Tukwola, 23 years of age, won the audition to perform the special number written and composed by Fonoti PJ Yeriko of the Ministry of Education, Sports and Culture.
The skies here over Apia tonight. The occasion has been big and it heralds 2 weeks of fantastic competition as the best from around the Pacific in 26 sports representing 24 countries, some 5,000 strong, do battle here in the capital of Samoa. It's been a night of nights. The rain stayed away and we've seen on display some of Samoa's finest.
The culture, the spectacle, the choreography, the atmosphere, the theme, a reflection of both history and the future, a celebration on behalf of the 24 participating nations, the opening ceremony of Samoa. In all the years I've been coming here, I've never seen it, never seen such a spectacle. The people involved behind the scenes, who came up with the concept, designed the ceremony, and then delivered what we have witnessed tonight, will live long in the memories of all of us. A very, very proud day for Samoa.
Sisila al mamalo le tato watunuu, mai tafau fia o le tato motu, pa malo le tapuai, pa malo le lava papale, he o leua, pa penao te tala aloa ia, ia le ta'alonoa, kuna sefulu ma leono o le ta'alonga le Pasifika I Saute, I Samoa nei, I le o ngata tonu o apia, pa malo faftai le tau tapua inga, ia o lea ua sao mauli le faa moe moe, ai mai te tala aloa ia o le nei faa moe moe. Thank you, Samoa, for your support and prayers. I believe tonight's successful opening is testimony of God's blessing upon the beginning of the next 14 days of spectacular display of sports, of creativity, not just from Samoa, but from all the participating countries. We welcome the delegates, we welcome the athletes, we pray for strength, continuous respect for each other as you battle it out on the various 24 sports that will be on display over the 14 days. We will be back again at the closing ceremony where the journey of the battles, the warriors continue and will be highlighted. And we will see who will be the winners and who will be the winners at heart.
The 16th edition of the Pacific Games, the biggest in the history of the event, has been declared open. The flame is lit. Now let the games begin. From Apia Park, I'm Brendan Toff on behalf of Verona Park and Ken Laban. From all of us here in Apia, a very good evening.
Oka Matango Fia. Wow, what an awesome start to the 16th Pacific Games here in Apia, Samoa. What an awesome moment for Samoa as well as the Pacific.
Congratulations to the 3,000 plus students that performed tonight. So that was an amazing and electrifying performance put together tonight. Welcome to all the athletes. We hope you've enjoyed the show and we look forward to bringing you coverage from the biggest sports event in the region starting tomorrow. We will see you then. Samoa, we on.
Tofa Soifua.
The holiday feeling that starts in the air. Then you emerge from the clouds to a place where your time is your own, where you have the freedom to be happy-go-lucky or pamper yourself in the lap of luxury, where you can dive into adventure, nourish your body and feed your soul. A place where you can plan every step or take it as it comes. This is your Samoan holiday, and it's always gonna be beautiful. Beautiful Samoa.